On day one, House members blocked a late attempt to consider legislation named for Kimberly Cates, a bill that would make home invasion killings a capital offense in New Hampshire.
161 having voted in the affirmative, 201 in the negative, the motion fails.
And while the Senate will consider a similar bill, House backers at least wanted the chance to argue it.
The Cates home invasion murder was as much as an event unforeseen as could be imagined, and the basis for the late filing of this legislation.
Another important bill before the House would require DNA samples be taken from convicted felons in New Hampshire and then put into a national data bank. It's a bill championed by the family of Kathy Glotty, whose 1971 murder in Franklin remains unsolved.
We're only one of three states that do not require felons to give their DNA for a national data bank. And to me, that's pretty devastating.
This session, there will also be a strong Republican push to repeal several revenue bills passed in the last session, ranging from the hot-button LLC tax to the so-called campground tax.
Being in the minority, it's an uphill battle to try to change things, but we're hopeful that at least we're going to get the message out there.
It might slow the process down, but that's just the price you pay in a democratic society of making sure that everybody of whatever disparate view has a chance to be heard, and then we come out with the best results that we can.
To that end, the governor makes no bones about where he thinks the attention should be.
With the budget, jobs, and making sure that we have a positive economic climate so businesses can prosper.
Josh McKelvin, WMUR News 9.